Trey Gowdy officially cleared to go after Lynch, Clinton. Well, that didn't take long, did it? Finally, Gowdy and the Judiciary Committee are going after Clinton and her use of the private email server. It's about time. House Oversight and Government Reform Committee Chairman Trey Gowdy has announced, along with House Judiciary Committee Chairman Bob Goodlatte, that the two will be jointly investigating the Department of Justice's handling of the investigation of former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton's use of a private email server, saying that the department's actions have left a host of outstanding questions that must be answered. Our justice system is represented by a blindfolded woman holding a set of scales. No entity or individual is exempt from oversight, the two chairmen said in a statement Tuesday. The host of outstanding questions pertain to subjects including, but not limited to, FBI's decision to publicly announce the investigation into Secretary Clinton's handling of classified information but not to publicly announce the investigation into campaign associates of then-candidate Donald Trump. FBI's decision to notify Congress by formal letter of the status of the investigation both in October and November of 2016. FBI's decision to appropriate full decision-making in respect to charging or not charging Secretary Clinton to the FBI rather than the DOJ. FBI's timeline in respect to charging decisions. In other words, a good number of the goofy, ridiculously things going on in the Obama-era DOJ are on their way to being brought into the light, and we couldn't be happier. Former President Barack Obama's Justice Department is as scandal-ridden gets, with former attorneys General Loretta Lynch and Eric Holder potentially on the hook for a bevy of misbehavior. Do you really think the liberals and Clinton were going to slide on all their corruption, scandals and wrongdoings? Maybe you need a reminder of a lot of the rotten things that went on during the Obama era. Let's take a look at a couple of the worst incidents. Operation Fast and Furious, in which thousands of guns ended up in the hands of cartel members and Holder became the first sitting cabinet member to be held by the House of Representatives. Lynch's infamous tarmac meeting with former President Bill Clinton before the investigation into Hillary Clinton's emails was announced complete, an incident that even former FBI Director James Comey found problematic, according to Fox News. Lynch is insisting to Comey to refer to the Clinton investigation as a matter instead of an investigation, a seemingly blatant attempt to quash any Democrat scandals during the race for the presidency. The list could go on, and with so many questions being linked to the FBI, I'd imagine that the walking and talking scandal that is James Comey will be a name in the news for some time to come. We may grow tired of hearing the same names and hearing about the same issues, but it is absolutely vital that justice prevail in Washington. Obama's DOJ failed the American people. It's time things were set straight, and I can't imagine a more capable man to sort the matter out than the bulldog that is Trey Gowdy. We've learned a lot since that first investigation, haven't we? It seems we now know that former FBI Director Comey drafted his letter on Hillary months before the interviews and the investigation of Clinton was even completed. Comey, you have some splaining to do. You see, you just can't draft an exoneration statement on Clinton, and then say there was no special treatment. Comey's statements and timeline were all over the place. But what can I say? Comey did after all work for Clinton for several years, didn't he? It's called sob.cover your own butt. Now, it looks like Comey's skit is up. It's time for someone to come clean and pay the Pied Piper. She said that the public record was complete. You will remember in her single press conference she said that she had turned over everything related to work to the Department of State. We know that that is false. We all know Hillary lied about the emails. She lied about the server. She also lied about Benghazi. Though I highly doubt any of that was in Clinton's book What Happened? It was pretty clear to most Americans what happened. Clinton lied and people died. Period.